that I didn't even expect that would be safe, that all this person just cares about sports and he just comes here just to eat or something, and actually he actually decided to change into Christ and he comes. There's just a guy that he was about to kill himself. He was about to kill himself, and we just started talking to him about God, and he accepted Christ. He did the listener's prayer, and he right there he became saved.
It gave me kind of, it's like a basis of friends that I know I could count on. They're close to God to help me through tough times and kind of help other people with their troubles too.
I was talking with some of the guys on the football team during FCA, and just like one of our meetings on Friday, and during that game on Friday, you know, I said, hey, let's go out to the middle of the field and, you know, center field, and, you know, let's pray. And we prayed in the middle of the field, and then a guy just like in the middle of the football field just accepted Jesus Christ.
He was, a few weeks ago, we had a youth pastor from Calvary Chapel Westbrook, and he came to our meeting, and on that day there happened to be only a few kids, the freshman and sophomore lunch, so he, you know, flat out said, well, let's go out to the lunchtime on, you know, out in the quad, and let's go talk to some students, you know, preach the word or whatever. And you know, some of the students that came to the meeting, you know, and I know myself, we were all kind of like, oh, like really right now? So we all went out there and, you know, talked to just a few kids, and just going and, you know, having the confidence to go out and talk to people, and then realizing later, like, you know, that was a good thing. And these kids that came with us to go talk to the other students, like, they, you know, felt like, oh yeah, now I can do that. Now I feel like I can talk to these students more often about Jesus Christ.
I've really built leadership skills, even though it might be annoying to other people, and I've really learned how to work as a team with other leaders, and I can go out on a sports team and know who my fellow teammates in Christ, and if I am having a bad day, I can go and talk to them, or if they know they're having a bad day, they know they can come talk to me, because we've made a connection somehow, sometime, through FCA.
Well, I think the biggest thing was Hume Lake, and you know, Dave being Hume Lake, and following up with people that made decisions and coming in and talking to them about the decision, and there is somebody that they can call on, that they can relate to, that would gladly speak with them about their decision, and as they change and make their walk, that Dave's been there to be instrumental in that.
First of all, I was involved with FCA when I was an athlete in high school and college, and that has had a big impact on my life, even though at the time I was probably not doing a lot of things that were good. That has, you know, a lot of seeds were planted and helped me to get back on track and really helped me in my faith. And I'd say more recently, I've been involved with FCA for about 26, 27 years as a coach, and we've seen many student athletes come to know the Lord and have a deeper relationship with the Lord. And all over Bakersfield, at Bakersfield College, we see a lot of students that have athletes that have gone on and done well, and that are in the coaching profession themselves, that are now involved with FCA. So we've seen a far-reaching effect, starting from people long before I was ever coaching, that had an influence and impact on me, and I was able to maybe encourage others, and you see those people that are being successful and prominent role in FCA here in Bakersfield.
One of the great events I look forward to every year is the Hume Lake experience. I've been here three different occasions with football teams, and you can just see the huge impact that it has on the student lives as they return back to their campuses. Now, you know, only God knows who's truly saved when we walk out of here, but I know lives are changed for sure. I see that daily when we come back from Hume Lake, and I know that the seed at least has been planted. Now, hopefully that seed will get watered and nurtured along the way. But here at Hume Lake, FCA brings teams every year for different sports seasons. And I know for a fact that it's just a huge impact on attitudes and the way our student athletes look at Christ when they return.
Well, I think what has caught my attention is just seeing kids want to learn about Jesus and want to be able to come and worship with other students and coaches and really kind of saying, oh, coach, I didn't know you were a Christian, and just having them have an opportunity to see us in a different area. And I think that's what's been really impressive for me, is to see these young student athletes be able to have an opportunity to come and learn about Jesus and having that venue to, you know, express their religious beliefs in a way where it's not restrictive, and it's just exciting to be able to talk to these kids at that level and to see them excited about learning about the Bible. And you know, most of the time as coaches, we learn more from the kids than they learn from us.
I've seen just a tremendous opportunity for coaches to get into the other side of it, not so much X's and O's, but get into character and values and understanding, you know, our relationship with God and those types of things. And I've been very fortunate to be impacted personally. I attend a Monday morning Bible study with a group of other coaches in town, and that has been a fantastic experience. Not only have I gotten to know these men very, very well, but I've also had the opportunity to study God's Word, and so that's been tremendous.
One thing about FCA is that it really unifies students and young people and coaches. You know, within the church there's, you know, different denominations, but the focus is salvation and the focus is Christ, and that unifies every Christian. And that in itself is something great, where people can come from, you know, they're different denominations and they serve the same God, maybe a couple doctrinal differences or whatever, but we never touch on that. It's all about Christ. And I think that's pretty awesome, that kids are gonna come to this classroom where we have our meetings. They're gonna feel safe, fellowship with other Christians, and be inspired and get their fill and ready to go out there and conquer the lost souls for Christ.